Hi friends, once again, welcome to Electronics Lecture Series. Ashok Jadhav welcomes you. Today we will study RC full wave trigger circuit for SCR. Previously we have studied two control circuits, that is a resistance trigger circuit and RC trigger circuit for SCR. In first case, we use only variable resistor to change the firing angle of alpha, but limitation there was we have control from 0 to 90 degree, that means half of the positive half cycle. In next circuit we have used resistance and capacitance, and because of that we had control over full half cycle, that is from 0 degree to 180 degree. Now today we are going to study this circuit, that is for full wave. That means our load, this is the load, our load requires a more DC voltage and more power, then what we do is we first use ordinary four diode bridge rectifier, this diode D1, D2, D3, D4. This is a bridge rectifier and it is a full wave rectifier. This AC input is converted into full wave rectifier and it is a full voltage, maximum possible voltage. Let us call this as a capital E DC. Capital E indicates that it is a DC and it is full wave rectifier voltage, right? So full voltage is first generated and then it is connected to load through this SCR switch. And we are going to change its firing angle in each positive up cycle. See that this is 0 to 180, first positive up cycle. This is a rectified negative up cycle again. Then 0 to 180, then 180 to 360. So all we have positive half cycles, right? And during each half cycle, we are going to change firing angle of this SCR. And here we will have a control over full half cycle in each half cycle from 0 to 180 degree, and therefore the load is provided with full wave rectified controlled power. And let us see how it happens here. See that this is the AC voltage, full wave rectifier voltage, this is the SCR, and we have here the resistance, variable resistor, and this is the capacitor. Now at onset of each half cycle, jab bhi koi half cycle ye aati hai, to ye voltage increase hoga, and because of this capacitor begin to charge through this resistor, and when voltage at this gate of SCR reaches to VGT, what is VGT? Gate trigger voltage for the SCR, and when that specific level VGT comes over here, this SCR turns on. And the moment it turns on, it works as a closed switch, and this complete EDC after that will coupled to the load. So voltage will be available for the load. And this happens in every positive half cycle, right? Now, if you reduce this resistance, this capacitor will charge to that VGT earlier. Let us consider the next slide. Here you can understand in this time profile, you see here, this is the rectified voltage versus time. On this time scale, I have shown two waveform. This is full wave rectifier voltage, and whenever that voltage is there, the capacitor voltage, this ramp like voltage, increase hone wala jo voltage hai, that is the voltage across capacitor. And you can see that as time goes, that voltage across capacitor increases, and somewhere it becomes VGT. This horizontal line indicates gate triggering voltage. Now how much time that capacitor takes to attain VGT is decided by the value of this resistor. We are taking capacitor as a fixed capacitor and we are wearing this resistor, right? See here, suppose that VGT is 20 volt, and see that capacitor begins to charge from the 0 volt. It increases, and the moment it attains 20 volt, SCR fires, and after firing you can see that the load voltage is present. The shaded area indicates that for that much duration, the load voltage and load current is available. Once again, at this pi, this input AC voltage becomes zero, therefore output voltage becomes zero. And at the beginning of the next half cycle, you can say, and once again, the same cycle is repeated. So if you reduce this resistor, SCR will fire earlier, alpha will be smaller. Earlier means conduction period will be more. Voltage and current will be available for load for larger duration, and that will deliver more power to the load. Now, if this resistance is increased to high value, then capacitor will take more time to reach to VGT, and therefore SCR will fire late in every half cycle. That means current and voltage will be available for load for this smaller duration, and this is how you can control the power smoothly. So circuit is very simple. Only thing is that it requires the bridge rectifier at the initial stage, and then the rest of the circuit is just R and C. So after rectification, there is no question of negative half cycle. Therefore, using just a single ECR, you have full blow controlled power, right? And the value of this is empirical formula. Empirical means it is found, it is decided after trial and error, and it is observed that it should be 50 times of T by 2, where T by 2 is the half period. You see, this is a one cycle, positive half cycle, negative half cycle. This is total, two half cycle together is the capital T, and T by 2 is the half T. So half of T multiplied by 50. So and this is after 157 by omega is the just conversion. So that's all about this RC full wave trigger circuit. See you next time. Bye.